Nice to be with you once again. I welcome you all once again. And I want to say congratulations. A big congrats to all AAC supporters worldwide, anywhere you are. I congratulate you and I also congratulate Mr. Sowore, for everything that happened during this election. Well, I can't see this and call it election. It's not election at all. And I still say that among all the contenders or all the parties, all the parties that contested for this election, AAC for me remains the best, remains number one, and remains the winner. The mind of God remains the best. You cannot call a brosucker the best candidate. You cannot call a thief the best candidate. To admit all of you that is saying Buhari is the best, Atiku is the best, articulated this and that, it means that you people don't want to move forward. And what will happen in this election is what is called total boycott. Nigeria people or Africans do like to boycott the will of God and the will of man. That's why that continent is still so backward. It's so backward. They don't want to know the will of God or the will of man. And it's a very shameful thing when somebody is not allowing the spirit to lead. When a nation fails to allow the spirit to lead or to know what the spirit is saying, go to the book of Revelation. You will see when John was prophesying what the Spirit is saying. What this, because it is the Spirit that controls. It is the Spirit that gives life. So a nation who fails to know what the Spirit is saying and to allow the Spirit to lead can never move forward, can never come out of darkness, can never come out of shame, can never come out of backwardness. Until Africa begins to allow things to grow natural, when you plant a tree, when you plant a seed, you allow it to grow naturally and begin to bear fruit. Until Africans begin to do this, that continent will still remain the way we are seeing it. By cutting the will of God, by cutting the will of man, is totally forcing things. No, we force things, artificial, we force things. Forcefully, this is what we are doing in Africa. Forcefully, forcing things that is not supposed to be. That life is not in your hand. Know that. I want all of you, you APC, PDP, all of you in that country called Nigeria, life is not in your hand. There is still a power that supersedes, that controls everybody, every man and every woman. This is all that I can say. For me, the winner is still Mr. Sowore. I don't care what anybody is saying. This is the mind of God. This is the only candidate that I see this candidate as exceptional. Is it a PDP or APC that is the one part by all means sharing money, giving money to the people? Until that country called Nigeria stop doing election sharing of money or giving out things, let everybody choose his candidate. If you share money or if you share rice or garri or anything, be arrested and thrown in prison until they stop this. I'm in Germany here. I've never seen in time election is coming. I see a party begin to share things for people to vote. I've never seen that before. I've been watching Americans. I've never seen American presidential candidates begin to share money or share things for what? For what? Until Nigerian people stop this and ban it. Say no more sharing anything during election. No more. Because I can't blame the people so much because they are very poor in the inside. That is how poverty poverty or hunger can cause somebody to look down on himself, not to be in the right senses. They have used hunger and caused people down there not to be thinking or reason like human being. So I want to just say congratulations, Mr. Sowore and all AAC supporters. I don't care what happened or what. This is not election. So all I want to say is that God bless you, Mr. President Sowore. I still see you the best. Heaven still see you the best. All you supporters, you are amazing. You are awesome. You are wonderful. I say thank you for your fight and for your braveness, for standing there trying to show them the difference between what they are doing or what they know. You are showing them how to do it. I'm proud of you. I want to say I'm proud of you. And may God strengthen you and empower you. Empower you more. The will of God, the counsel of God will surely happen. They are rejoicing. They are rejoicing for their evil, for what is coming upon them. Don't worry. We will see the downfall of the wicked. We will see the shame and disgrace that is coming, that's only upon them. All right, so have a wonderful day. And I want to tell you, just keep on believing God and trusting God and be praying for that country. Anybody who is wishing Nigeria, a man like Buhari or Atiku is an enemy, a strong enemy. And Buhari have been forcefully controlled, like forcefully, because it's only the devil that forced things for all the pastors that are prophesying that he is going to be the winner. Because they know that he will force it, whether people like it or not. They know. I also know, even a newborn baby, they know that Buhari will use everything. We forcefully, the same way he forcefully entered the first time. So, they are all gamblers. They know that that Jonathan remains the best. Because in that country, it is only few that can do what Jonathan did. It's only it is only few. That's why his name is written on gold. So they know that this man will forcefully hold on to power. So that's why they are prophesying it. They are all gamblers. They are all enemies of good, enemies of Nigeria. Anyone that is saying Buhari will win, his hand is soaked in blood. He's an evil person. So this is what I want to tell you. That is jumping up and down saying Buhari. What Buhari will offer you will close your mouth. You will not be able to talk again. Have a blessed day.